Here's my new acquisition. It's a little Kohler generator, 3.5 kilowatt, or yeah, 3.5 kilowatts. And the tag number dates it to around 1953, I think. And it's got a Gerritsen low pressure demand regulator. So it's got I got this off Craigslist, and the seller said it was a dual fuel carburetor. So obviously it's been running on propane. And it seems to be in remarkably good shape. It's got a remote oil filter back there. And I don't know what this, well, this, that valve goes to the sump, oil sump, and so I don't know if it was for quick draining. But then it's got this funny hose that, don't know what that would do. Maybe to fill it again? I have no idea. But it's got radio suppression plugs, wires, and coil cap, or magneto cap. It's an auto start machine. So this box looks quite a bit newer than the generator. And so we can let's see if there's more than one screw here holding this cap on. And voila. It looks like it might have everything here to be a automatic transfer switch kind of thing. Maybe it's just auto start. I don't see any big breakers in there that switch. I think that's a 12 volt rectifier, selenium rectifier maybe. So that big transformer down there is probably part of the battery charge circuit. That's a funny looking resistor. I'm assuming that's a resistor. Start solenoid down there. I'll mention the way of accoutrements out the back. It's got a start, run, stop switch. And the little button is the, I think it's the overcrank. Cranking reset. Yep. I'll start and crank and stop. It does turn over. Doesn't have compression on that one stroke, so I'm assuming the piston that had the valves open, or the cylinder that had the valves open, is probably the one that stuck. So my first order of business is to probably pull that cover off the side and see if I can get that valve unstuck. Cool little generator, weighs a ton for being 3.5 kilowatts. It almost matches the color of my Lister back there. That's a 12 kilowatt diesel generator. So we'll start digging into this thing. 2 just went, so firing orders 1, 3, 4, 2. One should go next. There's one. Here's 3. Three worked. 4. And 2. Yep. Oh, that's good news. All 4 plugs work. And the magneto works. It's an American Bosch, I think it says. There it is. American Bosch. There's the firing order. 1, 3, 4, 2. Well, the exhaust valve worked. Looks like intake valve's working. Guess I'll check the lash and see if it's just tight.
Well, here's another day. I've worked on it a little bit, put oil in all the cylinders and filled it with water. It's got to put oil in it. Hooked up a propane regulator. So I'm just going to see if it runs. I'm not messing with any of the electronics yet, so I'm going to try hand cranking it. Took the hose off the regulator. Nothing seemed to be wrong. So I put it together. I'm just going to crank it until it tries popping. Decided to pull the carburetor off. Fixed anything, but it's all back together again.
So,
let's
see if we can't get something going on here.
Well, I've got a few pops out of it, so I'm going to start up the camera again and
see if I can catch this on video. The first start.
I don't know what it is with this Gerritsen demand regulator, but I just can't start this thing with on propane with that regulator the way it is. And I don't know if it's a regulator, might be the mixer, I'm not sure. It's kind of a hokey looking mixer on the carburetor. But anyway, what I did is I just took off the plug, plumbed in a gas line right there. Goes up to a little tank right there. And starts up great. And I used the drill motor running backwards, cranking it backwards by hand to get a charge back in the field of the generator. And so now it's putting out 110 volts. So let me set this thing up and I'll start it up on gasoline and run a couple of loads on it.
are back on. It's all hooked up. And I've never been able to start this without some sort of starting aid when it's been on propane. So this will be the first time if it starts all on its own. Another thing, this regulator doesn't have a primer on the backside, a little primer button, so it may take a while to get gas all the way up to the carburetor. I have no idea where these things should be set at either, in terms of this side needle and the bottom thing that I just made.